South. You know, I was born in New Jersey, guys, and I have a little bit of the States and Toronto, and I say y'all, and I say tall, and I say coffee. And yeah, so I'm a little Jersey'd out, a little Toronto out. But I was having a really good morning, and I want to see how everybody was doing, because I just feel really blessed by the good Lord, and I wanted to give a shout out to the good Lord and thank him for everything he does for me on a daily basis. I literally ran, I think it was five laps around the church, and I was so grateful to do that. Like, I ran five laps around the whole church, and it was awesome. And beforehand, I worked out a lot with my dumbbells. They was the 25 pound, I usually do the 30, so I wasn't as tired, and yeah, I felt like, oh my goodness. When I picked up the dumbbells today, I was like, Meta, you got the 30? I was like, these feel so light. I was like, I'm getting really strong. I'm like, this ain't the 30, it's a 25 pound, Meadow. And she put my dumbbells in the car for me. But I want to give a shout out to the good Lord, because he is great. He is amazing. He does everything for me. And I am so, 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 so grateful. And today I was looking at that little palm tree again. That looks like palm tree. The skies are pink. I'll post some pictures after. I took pictures of the sky being more pinker, but oh my goodness, it's so beautiful. Everybody's picking up their kids. That's my good friend. He was the bishop before here. Look at that. How's everybody doing this morning? Good morning to everyone. How's everyone doing? Are you having a blessed morning? I am. What do you do in the morning? Tell me, I want to hear in the comments, what is your routine like in the morning? I'm an entrepreneur, I'm an online business owner, so I do have a lot of time on my hands, honestly, I do. And I don't like to waste my time. I'm not a lazy person, I'm not a person that likes to waste time, honestly. I don't like to waste time, so in the morning, when my daughter is like at her Bible study, I work out, and today I just ran laps around. It felt amazing. Something made me run, and I was like, I feel like running. I was like, it's too hot inside. I need to be outside. It was so, so hot. Let me see what the weather's like in Kamloops right now. It is. Give me one sec. I was outside. What a sports bra. 6 in Kamloops, and it's hot as anything for me. Get your blood going. Get your energy going. Work out, guys, in the morning, because it's the most amazing feeling in the world. Get up earlier. And and throughout the day, I'm with my babies, and I love being with my babies, and we have fun, and we think about what we're going to do that day. I might have a couple coaching calls to get somebody ready for the business, helping them out. I have my team Zooms on Friday, and our community Zooms on Wednesday, and, you know, I study here and there on my training. Look at this beautiful princess. Say hi.
Hello.
Did you get your donut?
Yeah.
What kind of donut did you have?
Old Spice.
Old Spice? Like the cologne?
I don't even know.
Are you serious? Is this shirt was called? All Spice, not Old Spice. She's calling it Old Spice. Hey, no Old Spice donut. It's All Spice, silly Willy. You're crazy.
Well, I just figured because old people eat it, so it's Old Spice.
Old fashioned donut? Was it old fashioned?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it was old fashioned.
Old fashioned has no spice. Crazy girl. So, this is what I have in the morning. My girl makes me my smoothie. She helps me out since I drive her here. She kind of puts my dumbbells in and makes me a smoothie. So, she's my little helper. Right, Meadow? Isn't it beautiful outside today?
Yeah.
What'd you learn? Tell everybody what you learned. Give us a little inspiration.
it was about the temple. I don't really remember.
What?
I was tired the whole time.
I was tired. She walked in the car and she was like, I don't want to go home. I was like, okay, I'm going to say hello to everyone. She was like, okay, I'm going to go get the donut. Well, give God the glory, because he is amazing. Hi, Fahana. Hi, Kushatha. Hi, Lena. God bless everybody. I want to give God all the glory. Hi, Eugene. Because he is great and he deserves all the glory. He's given me strength to work out today. Oh my goodness, my muscles are getting big, Meadow. Look at that. Yeah, they're getting kind of big. I think one's bigger than the other. Violet's always like, Mom, you're showing off your biceps. They're not that big because I'm small.
Go big or go home.
Yeah, that's what she tells me. Go big or go home. She's only six. Yeah, so work out. Get yourself healthy. Get yourself strong. The good Lord gives us the strength. And I'm really, really grateful for all the strength He gives me. When you give Him the glory and you thank Him for everything that you have, He will give you more. Wake up. Write 5 things that you're grateful for. Do that every morning. Even 10 things. Go big or go home. 10x it like Grant Cardone. Woo! And I do. And yeah, throughout the day, I'm just chilling with my family. And I work on my business here and there. And if anybody wants to see what my business is about, go watch the workshop. I host it. I'm really proud. That was a huge milestone. I hosted the workshop 2.5 years ago. I watched the workshop and started this business and was amazed by our business plan. Now I'm hosting them. So you don't have to. You don't have to even show your face. But that was a big, big thing for me because, yeah, it's. I want to help our community. I want to spread it to the world. It's like song. Joy to the world. I want to help the whole world. I want to help them to make tons of money. I want to help the poor. I even want to help the rich with their mindset. You know, some people are so filthy rich, but they're unhappy. Why? Because they never have time with their family, or they're not happy with their own way. So your mindset is very, very, very important. Me and my, you know, little friends that we went out and feeding the homeless outreach. We was talking about this. Sometimes the homeless people have a better mindset, and their little struggles of trying to get a house and maybe trying to get, you know, food is nothing compared to what's going on deep in someone's mind, the depression, the marital problems, the confusion, the feeling like they're held down but a ball and chain by their boss. I was looking, like, when we do outreach, when we give to the needy, like, some of them have some, I look at them, I'm like, wow, they have such good relationships. Like, they're all friends. They have their husband or their wife with them. They're laughing, they're having fun, they're hugging each other. Everybody knows each other, they watch out for each other. Like, they share. Like, I'm going up to them and they're trying to give me food and they're trying to give me stuff. I'm like, no, thank you, God bless you. Like, that's the first thing. Here, you want some? You want one? Here. It's like, and they have, and you look at where they are, and you look at where a rich person is, and they're like going through more even. So mindset is important, guys. Mindset is key. Work on your mind. Listen to inspirational podcasts, inspirational videos. I do that while I'm working out. I love Jake Ducey. I love Tony Robbins. Les Brown is a good one. I listen to Grant Cardone. I listen to The Rock. Joe Rogan is awesome. He curses a lot, but he's awesome. There's a lot of inspirational speakers. Louis Hoes. Is it Louis Hoes? I think it's Louis Hoes. He has a really, really good podcast. Look him up. I forget what his show is called, but it's really, really awesome. Louis Hoes on YouTube, and he brings, like, really great people on there and interviews them. But God bless everybody. I'm gonna get going here. We're gonna have an awesome day. I have a lot of good plans today with my children. Always, every day is a surprise. Do you love the surprises I do every day? Tell them about the surprises.
My mom always, she always surprises us and takes us somewhere, or she says, I got a surprise for you, and almost every day, and I feel bad. I'm like, why is she giving me so much surprises? Like, do I deserve it?
You do. Look how pretty you are.
Thank you.
Look how God made you so perfect and beautiful.
Thank you.
And I said this, we were, for like a couple of months, honestly, I worked on my business a lot. And I said, Mikey and Meadow, you have to help out. And we didn't go a lot of places. And I just worked on my business. Like, and whatever time I would get other to work on my business, I would. Like at night or in the morning or even in the afternoon when I first started. And I would, you know, cook, clean, help with the kids, do the laundry, get back to my business. Check on them, you know, fix them a little something. Play with them for a little bit, put them to bed, you know, work on my business. And Meadow was like, Mom, when are we going to go out? Mom, when are we going to do this? I'm like, Meadow, I know, I just got to do a few things. I'm working on our empire. Do you remember all those times, Meadow? Mommy worked hard, huh? Yeah. We all worked hard, didn't we? But what do we have now? What do we have now? How's it now? Like,
well, it's good now.
We have so much success. We have so much fortune, and we also learned how to, bond together, be sufficient, and we leaned on each other a lot, guys. Thank you. God bless you. We leaned on each other a lot. Thank you, girl. Kushatha. Yeah, so we learned how to be there for each other when we felt like we had no one. And even though we have our church family, we have our fam across the world, and we have our business partners, we felt like all we had was each other. And we did at the time. We had God, and we learned to cook together, clean together, be together, take care of the twins and Violet. And it made us powerful. And in the midst of it, you know, we learned how to eat more healthier and be careful. And, you know, and we did it. You know, every day, like, that I work out and I feel stronger, and like I got this Cadillac, and I got this beautiful little princess. Look how pretty she is. Aww. Oh, it's Fleetwood Mac. My friend was saying that she would spend $1,300 to go see Fleetwood Mac, but not, what's it called? Red Hot Chili Peppers. Oh my goodness, Red Hot Chili Peppers is coming! I gotta go see them!
Where are they coming?
I forget where they're going, but her daughter's going to see them, and I want to go.
I
want to
go.
My friend Megan. She works out with me sometimes here. Oh my goodness, I want to go see Red Hot Chili Peppers. I would pay $1,300, but it's like $600-$700 per ticket. I want to go. So, hi. Red Hot Chili Peppers did a bomb. I wish, what's his name, was around. Who do you think I wish I was around?
Kurt Cobain.
Yeah. I wish he was around. Yeah. I would have went and seen him in concert. I would have been like, crazy concert.
She would have been the mentalist person there. Like,
you know, I'll go crazy when I get wild. But I just act crazy. I'm not really crazy.
No.
Okay. Love you all. God bless. Remember, believe in you shall receive. Work on your empire every day. Any stone that's thrown at you, take it and build the empire out of it. Meaning any hurt, any pain, push it towards making tons and tons and tons of money. Spending time with your family. Work it out. Work on yourself. Work out every day. Wake up early. If you have to go to bed an hour late, okay, work on your empire. Do what you have to do. Do not sell. Do not settle for paycheck to paycheck to paycheck. No. You'll never get anywhere in life if you say paycheck to paycheck. You'll live mediocre and just get by. Don't do that. Don't just get by. Don't just settle. Work on your empire. Visit my website, www.georgiawilliams.ca. Go to my website, add your name and email, watch my workshop that I host. You're going to be amazed by all of my whole business plan, everything that we get you started with. Our tech team builds you a website, sales funnel, everything. We have the products. You don't have to go searching for the perfect products. We have the huge, incredible, good for you medical grade products that turn into high revenue. That's the tip here. High revenue. Wanting not 100, not 200 thousands of dollars you want to make, and that's what we're making, guys. Bye. William, the little dance for the hill.